Here we're going to look at a solution from a problem from the 2018 Australian Mathematical Olympiad. So this is question number 5. And so let's look at the statement here. So we want to define this sequence of numbers, an, and I should say this starts at n equals 0 to infinity, by this recursion. So we have a1 equals 1, and then an equals n times the quantity a1 plus a2 plus a3 all the way up to n minus 1. And that is for all n bigger than or equal to 2. Okay, great. And then our goal is to show that A sub 2018 is a multiple of 2018 squared. In other words, 2018 squared divides A sub 2018. Okay, so here are some hints to try as you maybe try the problem before we look at the solution. So the first hint is to find a one-step recursion for the terms of the sequence an. So we can do that actually pretty easily. We can write an in terms of just an minus 1. Then the second hint is to use a fact about relatively prime numbers. So we're actually going to prove the fact, although it's a little bit overkill, but I just want to give you guys kind of a flavor of what kind of number theory that you might need to use to solve this kind of competition problem. And then finally, the real goal will be to prove a more general statement. And if you can prove a more general statement, then this will be a special case of that more general statement. Okay, so I'll get this cleaned up and then we'll look at the solution. Okay, so let's start with a preparatory result, and like I said before, this kind of preparatory result would not really be required to be proved on the exam, but it's good to see a proof of it anyway, just to see some kind of number theory proofs that are used commonly in these types of competitions. So the limit is the following. So if the GCD of B and N equals 1, in other words, B and N are relatively prime, and N divides the product A times B, then that means that N has to divide A. So let's go ahead and look at the proof of, and we're going to use this pretty common fact involving the GCD. So I'll let you guys look it up. It's called Bayes' identity. And what that tells us is that there exists two integers, x and y, such that bx plus ny equals the GCD of b and n, but we know that that equals 1. And then furthermore, because n divides ab, we also know that there exists a z, so let's add that to the list, where ab equals n times z. Okay, so this GCD being 1 gives us this type of equation, and then n dividing ab gives us this type of equation. Okay, fantastic. And now what we want to do here is multiply this entire equation by a. So we'll multiply that entire equation by a, and notice that's going to give us abx plus nay equals a. Okay, fantastic. But now we know that AB is a multiple of N, so we can insert that. So this is NXZ plus NAY equals A, but now we can factor an N out of the left-hand side, and we have N times the quantity XZ plus AY equals A, but that's exactly saying that N divides A. Great, which achieves the goal for this lemma. Okay, so now that we have this proved, let's go ahead and look at the solution. Okay, we've got our preparatory result proved, and now we're gonna go ahead and look at the solution to this problem. And so I'm gonna write out two statements, and one is just this recursion right here. So we have an equals n times the quantity a1 added all the way up to an minus 1. And the next one is that an plus 1 equals n plus 1 times a1 all the way up to an minus 1 plus an. Great. So those are just the recursions for a sub n and a sub n plus 1. But now notice, if we multiply this one by n and this one by n plus 1, they will have a ton of like terms. So that's exactly what we're going to do. So we're going to go ahead and multiply this one by n and then this one by n plus 1. And notice that we have a lot of like terms. In fact, that allows us to subtract off a bunch of those like terms in the following way. So if we take n times an plus 1 minus n plus 1 times an, in other words, we're taking this bottom equation and subtracting the top equation, Notice that a1 will cancel because here we have n times n plus 1 times a1, and here we have n plus 1 times n times a1, and all the way up to a sub n minus 1 will cancel. So all of these will cancel, and all we're left with is n times n plus 1 times an. And let's go ahead and put my multiplication by n here and my multiplication by n plus 1 here. Great, so we know that this is equal to n times n plus 1 times an. But the great thing about this is we can easily solve this thing for an plus 1 in terms of an. In fact, here we have n times an plus 1 is n plus 1 times an plus n times n plus 1 times an. Okay, good. But now those are like terms, so that allows us to write the following equation: n times an plus 1 equals n plus 1 quantity squared times an. But notice this equation tells us the following. This equation tells us that n plus 1 quantity squared divides n times a sub n plus 1. Because we've written this entire left-hand side as a multiple of n plus 1 quantity squared. Next, we know that sequential numbers are relatively prime. In other words, n and n plus 1 are relatively prime. So we can write that as GCD of n times n plus 1 equals 1. So by our lemma, we have n plus 1 quantity squared divides an plus 1. Great, because look, this feeds right into our lemma. We have the GCD of n and n plus 1 is 1, and then we have n plus 1 squared divides n and an plus 1. So that's exactly this statement up here. Okay, but notice this is a very general thing. If we set n equal to 2017, which means n plus 1 equals 2018, then we have the solution, and so we're done. Okay, so I'm actually not going to stop it right here. I want to find a closed form for these an's, and there's a bunch of ways to do that pretty easily, and I'm not going to do one of those easy ways. I want to use something called an exponential generating function in order to find a closed form, and I want to do that because it's a nice tool to use, and it actually works pretty nicely in this problem. So let's clean up the board, and then we'll do that.